I've got just about everything they need here in Charleroi. Got the new trams, metro platform, old trams souped up a bit. Main thing they really need is some passengers. There's only about three on that one that left, although the next couple of stops should be the busy ones. Also need a darn good washing. May not show out too well on the video, but possibly you can see the only part of the windscreen that gets clean is where the windscreen wiper goes. And cars are rather grubby looking. The sides don't seem to be quite as bad, but you could hardly see your face in any of them. Wouldn't last 2 seconds in Switzerland. On the road up towards Humet, they're actually doing some track work. Temporary single track. This is one bit of line that will stay. Seems like for reasons unknown they're not running to Chile, so I don't know what's going on there. Something's a bit close. I wouldn't really like to see this driver driving our old cars at spur. At least he's not doing on off on off on off. Some old skips there, there's one here and one on the other corner. But can't remember the name of this place, but it reminds me of Mussman Junction. Been here before, on the other tapes, last tapes. I'm sure he held back until that truck had disappeared. By the way, this is part of 63 and Route 80, and both will go next month as far as I can understand. That's the third of these little skips, and this is a few hundred yards down the street. They make like nice flower pots anyway. have the little, they have the little repeater signals very often along the lines. Like in this case, they're only a couple of hundred yards apart, so you know immediately something's in the section and which way it's going. Still near the bridge, a couple of new bits of grooved rail, but if they're going to actually close the line, well, I don't imagine they'll be going into place. Perhaps the decision to close was fairly recent. Now it is a two-way street, believe it or not. Where the last lot of filming started on Route 63, which has been for a few minutes now, it was Courcelles. Well, having walked back towards the city, I then caught this tram, which I think was the same one that brought me there in the first place, and travel further around the loop back towards Charleroi in an anti-clockwise direction. Well, where I happened to get off was the end of not an ambulance, that's the tram weaving its way through this village. They don't make the full circle back to the city. Where I happen to get off is where you change to the modern cars for a faster ride into town. I wasn't sure how they got back, and that explains that they don't. They go back the way they came. A Vicinal car full of people. Well, they're mainly school kids, but still, at least they're passengers. Many cars today have only had half a dozen or less passengers in them, but this is a full one heading towards Morage. Firstly, La Louvière. Something you're allowed to do with a cam controller, although I suppose you won't do it now, is back notch if you wish, provided you remain in the correct notches. All the way to off that time. He came back a bit then, I think. Getting a few pops and bangs out of it too. It seems to be in a dreadful hurry. He's still nodding off. That's off in case you've forgotten. Not exactly smooth. You can see in Charleroi, and we won't see till there's a curve, is three trams in a row. Sorry it's a poor picture, but as I said this morning, windows are a bit dirty around here these days. Going back, I think he just had to set signals or points or something. And he's sneaking into the depot, and there's the one I just jumped off. Outside La Louvière depot. Another car, obviously it needs a good wash. That's the one that just ran in. There's the shed up there in the distance. And this is a short distance beyond La Louvière town, heading towards Mirage. Probably this bit of track will remain in use after the lines cut back to La Louvière, mainly because of the location of the depot here, but no one seems to really know yet. Quite a simple little section interrelator there. The normal running wires come towards each other and terminate at an interrelator in the middle. On the left-hand side, the parallel short wires are connected directly, right-hand side fully insulated, and thus the current's carried straight across. Eventually at the right-hand end, the three wires blend again, and that's where the change of current takes place. Very simple and quite effective, I presume. Articulated car had come into the terminus. Seemed to very quickly change ends. Let's see if it comes around this way in a moment. Don't know where that music's coming from, but it's certainly loud. Don't carry passengers down here. He said. case you haven't already noticed, some of the track work is a bit on the rough side. This, by the way, is just near Mullanwelts. The railway station is just over to the left. And this is part of Route 80 and 30, which are due for condemnation next month. Perhaps I was a bit close to his liking. And that's where 80, heading back towards Charleroi, passes over 30. But when you're up there, you don't really even notice that this is down here.